Agenda item 8E is a request for cash match increase for the VAWA ASG salary supplement. Solicitor Cabral, good morning, sir.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman, members of the commission.
Good morning.
I'm coming before the commission this morning asking for help. Our domestic violence prosecutor, VAWA funded, left our office in August of this year to take a higher paying position at the VAWA also district attorney's office. Since then, the position has been vacant, going on 3 months now. Even though we have posted the position numerous times, actually a total of 6 times since then, we've only received 2 applicants. One gentleman who's been unable to pass the bar exam, because hence he's not qualified. Another gentleman who terminated from college in the public defender's office. So essentially, we've had no applicants for this vital position. As everyone knows, we've been receiving this VAWA Violence Against Women Act grant since 2018. It's a $50,000 annual grant. The county, thankfully, has provided a $19,000 cash match, which also pays for benefits, which has allowed us to pay a $46,000 annual salary. Unfortunately, in 2021, that is just not a competitive salary for an attorney. If you survey the amount of available prosecutor jobs on the Prosecuting Attorneys Council website this morning, there's an excess of 40 prosecution jobs. Our position is the lowest, 46. Everything else ranges from 61,000 up to 85,000. So if we were to keep this current salary structure, we're just not going to be able to fill this position. The fact that we have a VAWA grant shows that we have this need. It's a lot of work. In essence, we're on track to have about 500 domestic violence cases this year. And Judge Evans is here, and he can certainly provide some more statistics. That's about double what a normal assistant district attorney's caseload is with the DA's Office of Superior Court. They're asking someone to do double the work for a lot less substantial pay. So, and also taking into account that there's a firefighter position posted on the county website paying $41,000, just requiring a GED degree. So again, the current salary is just not competitive in today's job market. But we are asking if the county considering increasing the cash match to $19,000, we think we can increase the salary to $60,000, which is still on the low end of what's available of the prosecutor jobs. At least we'll at least draw some more interest. That will, of course, require an additional $17,000, increasing the county match from 19 to 36. I think we are at the point 3 months in where we're having 2 attorneys covering 3 judges or 3 courtrooms. That it's just not going to be sustainable. I know Judge Edwards has been very patient in allowing either non-legal staff to staff his courtroom, because again, this position is in Judge Edwards' courtroom, or he's just waiting until I'm doing my cases in front of Judge Turner and going to his courtroom, or he's rescheduling them to different times of the day of the month or different times of the day. By definition, one person doing basically the work of 3 or 4 attorneys, you just got to have everyone in state court has worked so hard to address the backlog that was created by COVID, and we have done that. But I think if you don't fill this position, if you're not addressing the cases at the same time and efficiency as before, by definition, you're going to create a backlog, which is something we don't want to do. I'll turn to Black Judge over to come up here if he wants anything to add. But with that, I'll be able to answer any questions that you might have.
Any questions for Solicitor Cabral?
Is there any potential for a greater grant, grant?
And I've addressed that with Mr. Todd, who's helped us write the continuation grant every year. And he can certainly add to. Number one, if there's additional funds, and we apply every year, but that's a 4-year grant we've activated every year. Historically, they give the same amount to every grantee nationwide that we can ask. And at least you meant what Mr. Todd's alluded to, if there's additional funds, they may allocate that in the next grant year, which would be next year. But I don't think it's anything you can certainly count on, at least historically speaking.
Any other questions? Thank you, sir.
Thank you.